If you've been around my channel for a while, you know what it means when I'm not drinking beer during a video, so I won't bother explaining it here. I got this little package here from a company called Circuit Pop in the States. The guy that runs it, Cam, reached out to me and said, "Hey, I'm sending you a kit. Can you do something with it before Halloween?" So, okay, I guess so. It took a little bit longer to get here than he expected because UPS decided to, drag it behind their truck or something. So I'm hoping it's okay. And it just showed up here. So I figured I'd get into it and just make sure it's okay. And then, being a kit, I'll build it. The bag looks a little crumpled, but I think it's okay. Let me just get this out here onto the bench. So that's a fun looking circuit board. Neat art. A couple of different colors going on. He calls this a Cackling Mummy Halloween DIY electronic kit. I guess that's what it is. So there's this cool looking little circuit board. I guess orange resist with white silk screen. So that's kind of cool. Not too many components on the back and a fairly simple etch. So we'll get to that in a second. There's most of the rest of the components all stuck to the speaker's magnet. Did anyone puncture the magnet through the speaker through their rough shipment? No, that looks okay. We've also got a little chip here, a couple of LEDs, couple of looks like capacitors. Push button switch, a slide switch, speaker, battery holder. Yeah, not too much to it. Then there's this little chip here, which I'm assuming is a microcontroller. Oh, that's hard to read. RBDAD 4000, I think. Never heard of it before. I'll see if I can look that up in a bit. Just for fun, I should try and just reverse engineer what this schematic is, because I couldn't see any schematics on the website. Not that you need it to build the kit. It's just fun to do. At least I find it fun anyways. So this kit came from looks like a small company in the States called Circuit Pop. I found somewhere on their website that they are only a little, in July they're a year old, so fairly new company too. Anyways, here's the kit featured on the front page of it. And there's the kit. Oh, the price just, oh right. So it was initially showing American money, but since the website's smart enough to know that I'm in Canada, it's localized it for me. It looks like this price is likely going to be over by the time you guys see this video. The Americans get 3-day shipping on it. That's pretty cool, though. For the rest of the world, 7 to 20 days. It took a little bit less than 7 days from when he said he was sending it to when it actually got here, even with the abuse that UPS gave this one. Anybody who's got any kind of soldering experience at all should be able to do this kit no problem, even a beginner. It's a nice straightforward little kit. So it looks like he's got a lot of interesting stuff on his store here. I don't know if I've seen this particular USB tester before. That's kind of interesting. A lot of it is the familiar stuff that we've seen before, just the benefit of buying it from somebody, you know, in the same continent as you are, is you don't have to wait a month for shipping from China. Well, that didn't take too long. It actually took me longer Googling the part number for this little microcontroller and not finding it. So I still don't know exactly what it is other than it's a little 8-pin microcontroller. So this isn't especially confusing, not that anybody expected it to be. The positive power comes in to pin 7 of the microcontroller. The ground comes in through this switch to pin 5. And that doesn't match any microcontroller that I'm familiar with. It's not PIC, it's not ATtiny, it's not STC, it's not the Paduke, I don't know. It's something else, whatever. The speaker is connected to pins 6 and 8, just directly. This switch here is the push button switch, goes to pin 1, and the two LEDs are in parallel coming off pin 2. And, oh yeah, and there's a little capacitor across the power supply lines just because there has to be a decoupling capacitor. You just always want that. That's good karma, good posture, good practice. Yeah, that's what it is. It's good practice. But as interesting as that was, let's get to building this, because that's really why it's here. I think I'm just going to work on it on my little silicone mat here to kind of protect the bench a little bit. Where should we start? You want to start with the most challenging thing, the surface mount components? Yeah, that's a reasonable thing to do. That's completely the opposite of what I normally do, but why not? So as usual, when you're soldering surface mount with an iron, generally tin up one corner pad, and I've just done two there because I'm big and awkward. The reason I banged the camera is because I don't know the size of my head because I'm wearing my Optivisor. Because I am old and awkward. And this surface mount stuff is itsy bitsy. And for somebody right-handed, I chose the wrong side. This is going well. So I'll just take that one tinned pad and reflow it. How does that look? I think I've got most of them kind of half-assed lined up there. Just to give me a fighting chance, I'll drown it with a bit of flux. And I'll get this there. Clean that. I said clean. People that are used to doing surface mount are going to be laughing at me or crying, one or the other, but this is much smaller than what I'm used to doing, but if an old dude like me can do it, I'm sure you can manage it too. Have I made a solder bridge? Of course I have. That's what this is for. That's not super pretty, so I'm just going to give it a quick reflow with my heat gun, and hopefully it should pull itself back onto the pads where I've nudged it off. Yeah, that'll do. I never claimed to be really good at surface mount soldering. I've got to get more practice. So next is, I just need one of these capacitors, but thoughtfully, there's two of them in here, because as usual, they're tiny and easy to lose, and again, we'll try and do this properly. Solder one pad, let's get a little bit on there. Maybe I will use the ceramic ones again, so they don't steal heat away from what I'm doing here. That's more like it. Do you see that? That's actually decent. By my standards. That'll do. Okay. So next we'll put the power switch on, I guess. It just goes over there. Could probably solder it on either side, but I think I will solder it this way so that it's the majority of the switches showing from the back. And this is through hole, so this is where I'm much more comfortable. Zoom in? Okay. Is that somewhat aligned? Let's remount that and hold the switch in place. There we go. Cleaning, cleaning, cleaning. Always cleaning the tip. There. Not huge gobs of solder on there, not even too much flux. Nice. Cut that off nice and flush. Keep the front of the board fairly clean looking. Right. What's next? This little clicky tactile switch. So it's a through-hole switch, but the pads and the board are surface mount. So, that's not pliers. There. Get a pair of pliers and bend those guys out so it can pretend to be a surface mount component. treat it like a surface mount component. Just tin up one pad. Okay, and the rest of them are fairly well aligned. I think that'll do. Good. What's next? The LEDs, I guess. What color are these LEDs? Kind of orangey. Okay. And it's showing the positive goes to the left on both of them. That's the long lead. How do I want these to go through there? Probably like that, I guess. Let's give that a little bendy poo. And how does that look? Looks pretty good. Where should I trim those off? Right about there. This guy, eye patch of blue tack, hold it right in place. That looks good. And actually, I'll set it up on there just because. Quick cleaning. That's reasonable. That's funny. Yeah, I'll just repeat with the other one. Fun looking little dude. Okay, what's left? The speaker, which goes there. Where's some of those cutoff component leads? Tune up the speaker pads. It's good enough, I guess. Well, that's going to be fun. That magnet keeps stealing my component leads. Maybe I should have used copper wire. Now, those have to bend down and go through those holes there. So that can go that way, that can go that way. Okay. Quick little bendy bend. This is nice and relaxing, you know. Despite the annoyance of dealing with that tiny little surface mount stuff, I just like chilling out and building a little kit. Nice, easy kit. My brass shavings cleaner thing is starting to get a little choked up with bits of solder. It's not cleaning my tip as well as it should anymore. Did those take? Yeah, those look like they took. I'm not sure how you clean your soldering tip cleaner. Talking about this thing here, right? It's got all kinds of little blobs of solder down in the bottom of it for me cleaning my iron. So, anyway, back to the kit. Looks like all that's left is the battery holder, which is for 2032. Do I have any of those kicking around here? Yeah, there's one that just goes in there. Okay. And it looks like it got a little bit squished by its gentle treatment by UPS, but we'll manage here. That goes on there. This one down here is just a mechanical holder. It's not doing anything. The one up there is the electrical connection. And I expected those to have a bit more thermal mass than they do. That's good. So, just the mechanical connection here. That stuff doesn't conduct heat all that much. My fingers aren't even slightly burning. This one here. Throw a little bit more solder in there just for heat conduction. Okay, that thing's got a lot of heat in it now. Yikes. There it is. All done. All right, let's throw a battery into this guy and see what he does. Okay, switch is on. Oh, that battery got any juice in it? I probably should have checked that before I started. Yeah, not ideal. Okay, let's see if I got a fresh one here. Yay, Dollarama! That's hilarious. So when it's in idle mode, the eyes are just slowly PWMing. He's a little cross-eyed, but I like that. And then when you push the button, he makes noise. Well, isn't that fun? So thanks, Cam, for sending that in. I'll link to his website down below, or actually I'll link directly to this thing. I'm not sure how many of this kind of donated kit things I'm going to do. This came from an American seller, a North American seller. So I'm a little bit more inclined to do things for North American sellers. For overseas sellers, I might do the occasional kit build, review, freebie thing like this. But only if it's something more spectacular. But for North American, little North American company, I'm absolutely happy to show off some of the fun things that he's got in his store. Questions, comments, etc. down below in the comment section. You know the drill. Go easy on me. I already told you I'm not that great at surface mount soldering. I need more practice. I know that. I'll talk to you later.